set for one fall. Introducing first, from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, weighing 287 pounds, Cactus Jack.
Some interesting comments.
Bang, bang.
Oh, thank you very much for that bang bang. Some interesting comments from Cactus Jack early on in the program during the Ross Report, and we'll talk about the boxes and what they meant to sing and what they will be coming up this Tuesday. Let's go back to Gary.
And his opponent from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 251 pounds, the
Z-Man. Jim Ross is exactly right, saying that the Z-Man is one of the hottest athletes in world championship wrestling right now. And he really is. Right now, during the comments on the Ross Report, as this match gets underway, he talked about the gym, the boxes with Cactus Jack. And as it was announced yesterday right here on TBS during World Championship Wrestling, we do understand that the final box will be delivered to Sting during the Clash of Champions here on TBS this Tuesday. We have seen Cactus Jack, Abdul the Butcher, cakes, parties, girls, just about everything. And I'm assuming when the final box will be delivered, we will find out who's the man behind all this, who has been sending Sting the boxes. You know, many people feel there's a lot of speculation going on. Many people feel it's been Paulie Dangerously, because now that Ravishing Rick Rude is here, and now this comment has been made during Halloween Havoc, that was the perpetrator. Well, we will find out, man. Join us for the Clash this Tuesday here on TBS. Front face lock. Z-Man needs to wrestle Cactus Jack here. He doesn't need to get into a brawl or a fight. And of course, he needs to keep the action in the ring, and Z-Man goes right to the arm. By the way, speaking of Jim Ross and the Ross Report, I'll be with Jim during the Jim Ross Show on AM 750 WSB here in Atlanta, taking your calls tonight at 9 o'clock. We'll talk about the Clash and all the happenings of World Championship Wrestling. So make sure you tune in. What a view that was, huh? Cactus Jack upside down. Right now, Z-Man is wrestling Cactus Jack, and Cactus Jack showing us that he's more than just a wild brawler. Reversal Hammerlock, reversal Z-Man, and Cactus wisely goes to the rope. Apparently, Cactus Jack sees someone out of the crowd that he knows. I hope he's not looking my way. Right hand to the face, and Z-Man back to the corner. Z-Man, who has been the world TV champ, one half of the U.S. Tag Team champ. Cactus Jack that time dug one of those front teeth right to the forehead, as well as a finger into the eye at the same time. Forearm, not much effect on that one. But Z-Man is dazed anyway. Face first to the near side, right turnbuckle. And now it's getting into a brawl, and when it does, Cactus Jack more than likely will prevail. Z-Man. Elbow, and Cactus lumbers back to the corner. A drop kick. And look at Cactus. Hard to get him off his feet. He's on the outside. Z-Man should stay in the ring right now and leave Cactus Jack on the outside. So many weapons for this wild man to use. And Z-Man up on top. Now he's wrestling a smart match. Also, fans, I'd like to remind you that we have a very special preview.
Don't you laugh at me. Don't you laugh.
That is the closest I've ever seen Cactus Jack to showing emotion other than a sneer or a smile ever. Anyway, as we were saying, we have our preview of the Clash tomorrow night. all day tomorrow on the Wrestling Hotline with Tony Schiavone's report. Tony Schiavone talks, so make sure you call with some special features. A big trivia question for you to answer. Hot tip of the week. And a preview of the Clash tomorrow night on the Hotline.
Ask them. Come on. Ask the kook. Ask the kook. Come on.
Z-Man was saying right there, ask the kook. Obviously referring to Cactus Jack. Give Z-Man a lot of credit. He's been wrestling a smart match so far. Twice, Cactus Jack has gone down the floor. And both times, wanting the Z-Man to come down there with him. And he wouldn't go for it.
Both men are back up now.
But it's Cactus Jack with the first offensive move. Since both men established a vertical base. Left hand. And once again, a bite to the head. Into the corner. Right hand. Crashed up to the head again. Z-Man with a great counter move. Appeared to be a Cactus Jack clothesline. He snatched it out of the air. And put him right down to the mat. Wherever you are in the state of Georgia or around the world, we welcome you to the main event. Very excited you could be with us. I'm Tony Schiavone, your host, and of course we'll have some comments from Missy Hyde a little bit later on about the Clash. And Van Hammer and Cactus Jack have a big match, as you know. And Cactus Jack, earlier on the Ross Report, called Van Hammer a video star. But heavy metal Van Hammer is much more than that. Well over 6'6", 300 pounds from New York City. It's going to be a great match with he and Cactus Jack this Tuesday on The Clash. Standing side headlock. Z-Man holding on. Shoots him into the right side. Oh! The big guy came off, knocked Z-Man down, a headbutt that time. Z-Man is stunned, and out goes Z-Man. Now this is where Z-Man is going to find himself in some jeopardy unless he can roll back in the ring quickly, but he can't. What was he reaching for? Surprisingly enough, Cactus Jack goes back in. Apparently, Cactus Jack was reaching for a lady's purse, or
I don't know, and I don't even want to try to speculate here. There's a forearm.
You are certainly at a disadvantage when you are on the outside and your opponent is standing in, because you have to crawl in, bend underneath the ropes, and that means you take your eyes off your opponent, just like Z-Man is doing right there. And when you take your eyes off your opponent, you are at a disadvantage. That is why many of the great athletes like a Stinger, even a Z-Man, would rather, when they're wrestling Cactus Jack, would rather go into the ring first than Cactus Jack. And you'd be surprised the arguments which ensue between promoters and athletes about who's going to go to the ring first. When there's a Cactus Jack in there, it's really a disadvantage to go in the ring secondly. Good shot at the maniacal Cactus Jack as he works on the face of the Z-Man. Reverse chin lock, and Randy Anderson checking in. Not only pressure on the neck, but that knee, right knee, is firmly between the shoulder blades, pulling back on the spine also. So that's a very painful move. Z-Man just trying to power out here. Doing a darn good job. Z-Man fans, come on, Z-Man, and he's up. Elbow in. And a knee. So Cactus Jack waiting for it. And a stomp right between the blades one more time. There's his move. His version, our form of the DDT, and that should be on. No, Z-Man with a surge of energy kicked away. catches. Out goes Z-Man. He's in trouble now. Z-Man is out on the floor. Cactus Jack's up on top. We've seen this so many times. He missed. Cactus Jack missed that big elbow off of the apron to the outside. Fans encouraging Z-Man to get up, and the fight goes on outside. Roundhouse right. Clothesline. Z-Man balanced up on top. Cactus running in circles. Flying body press. He didn't get the pin, and actually that time Z-Man missed on that flying body press. He was up high, could not come down, and in one smooth move could not hook the legs. That time a drop kick. The same move he used to win the World TV title. Oh, he almost got it. 2.5. Sleeper. And what a sleeper. Belly to back on the inside. The Cactus Jack's going to win it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Cactus.